Dear friends, welcome to our 9th Ukrainian traditional Ukrainian lunch in Davos during World Economic Forum. Ukraine is so interesting because it has so many challenges, and one of them is our strategic locations. You cannot imagine how many times I have heard the question, Viktor, where are you? Where Ukraine is going, east or west? And today we raised this question by ourselves, and we want to tell you that from our point of view is wrong question. This is wrong dilemma. Ukraine has combined our European values and our very special relationships with Russia. Ukraine east or west, it's like Ukrainian lunch, borscht soup or cabbage rolls, first or second course. Dear friends, please try both. And you know, I want to offer you to use this lunch as brainstorming for further intellectual food discussions and conversation, and with our, of course, intellectual chef, Christian Freeland. Bon appétit. And Christian, floor is yours. Thank you very much.
Okay, дуже-дуже дякую, Вікторе. You can see why Viktor is so successful in such a smoothie, because he managed to turn the fact that Ukraine indeed does have many challenges into an attractive quality. I trust most people in this room actually share that belief, perhaps out of some sort of internal masochistic impulse, because you are all interested in Ukraine and friends of Ukraine, and I am too. I'm Ukrainian. I'm very glad to be here. We're going to have a great discussion. Viktor has asked me to end promptly at 2 o'clock, and we're going to have a combination of discussion with our really esteemed and heterogeneous panel, and then we're going to throw the conversation open. So first, I'm going to invite our panelists to come out and join us. They're being held in a green room, and they're supposed to be able to hear me, so come on out, panelists, and take your seats. And while they're coming in, here they are, I see them, I'll tell you who it is. It's a real mixture of Ukrainian officials, Ukrainian opposition politicians, прошу, пане Кожара, esteemed European and Russian politicians and experts. So here we have Mr. Leonid Kozhara, he is the foreign minister of Ukraine. Yuri Boyko, he is the vice prime minister of Ukraine. Mr. Kudrin, Alexei Kudrin. He is, I'm gonna risk offending others by saying Russia's most prominent economist, former minister. Now in academia, perhaps not for long. Javier Solana, one of the most eminent leaders of Europe. A man who needs no introduction in many different arenas, Vitaly Klitschko. One of Ukraine's sports heroes turned politicians. And Arseniy Yatsenyuk, another one of Ukraine's leading politicians. So in a moment, I'm going to take my seat, and we will have a conversation among the panelists and with everyone here. Before I do that, I hope you noticed as you were coming in, Ukraine not only has entered the internet crowdsourcing age, many Ukrainians are leaders in it. In my own work building the consumer digital platform for Reuters, some of our top engineers are actually from Lviv. We use them, they're terrific developers, and I know there are a lot of great Ukrainian high-tech people here. So in keeping with that Ukrainian strength, Viktor and his team organized voting on this ever constant, difficult Ukrainian question, should it be Ukraine east or west? Viktor offered us a number of options, and now we're gonna see how people in the hall voted on that. So could we see the results, please? Okay. I can't actually read that screen. 57% for the EU. Okay. Natalka, can you shout out the answer so I can tell the panelists too? Come on. 6% for the customs union, Mr. Kudrin. You have your work cut out for you. Okay. No. No union with anybody, only 8%, okay? Okay, so with the customs union, join Europe, 10% still, Mr. Kudrin. This is, you still have your work cut out for you, even with that softer option. Okay, and 14% of Ukrainians wanted both ways, a very popular Ukrainian choice historically. And 5% don't choose anything at all. Okay, so that's how the hall voted. We're gonna hear in a minute how the panel voted, and I am going to sit down to be part of the, actually, you know what, I'm gonna start from here, not to interrupt. So we will start with, as is appropriate, since this is a Ukrainian lunch, our senior Ukrainian politician. I'm going to ask Yuri Boyko, віце-прем'єр-міністр України. Просимо вас до слова. І може ви могли би почати з цим питанням, яке має робити вибір Україна?
What should be the choice for Ukraine, east or west?
So you give the panel first to a power to. Okay, thank you very much. First of all, thank you Viktor Pinchuk, his wife Lena, his team for organizing this such delicious event, and we are often guests in such events, since it's very important to have possibility to speak with people, to explain our position. And what I want to say before, that it's very difficult for us to say we're going to right or we're going to left, because very many issues can be decided before nation, before people make this choice where they must be. And I think it's very important in this situation to have a good economy, in order if country's economy strengthened, in country, if country is economy built, it's much more easily to make this choice. And what I want to say is that we have a new government today which have very ambitious plans about building new Ukrainian economy, which is maybe usual model for Europe, but it's new model for our country, for Ukraine, because the base of this model, we make priorities in our economy, we choose the industries who will be the moderators of all the economy totally, and we are going to give financial support and lost support to these branches, to these industries, in order them to lead our economy forward. We chose 10 branches of industry, 10 directions of economy, who will lead us to ambitious numbers of growing GDP, which are going to decide, especially this and next year. That's why our activity today is directed to economic growth, and we consider it as the base of our political stability and the base of our future, especially future with European Union, because according to our law, according to position of our presidents, Ukraine have chosen European Union. That's why it's very important for us to build economy which will lead us to this direction. Thank you.
Okay, so you say Ukraine has chosen European Union. Mr. Boyko, can I just ask which of those five options did you vote for?
I mentioned that first of all, we need strengthen economy, as I said, but we have 10 priorities in our economy. 10 branches of industry who will improve in each, who will lead us to our, who will make our choice, and who lead us to European Union. And all these branches will be the locomotives, the moderators of this way. Today we begin working about how to realize this way. It's very difficult, it's not easy way, but It's model which was useful, which was used in Europe. It's new for our country, but we are ready to go this way.
Okay, дуже вам дякую. We will now hear a few words from Ukraine's Minister of Foreign Affairs, Леонид Кожара. Прошу.
Thank you, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to thank Viktor Pinchuk and his foundation for again and again organizing conferences on Ukraine's future. And this is the all-time dilemma, east or west. For me, it sounds like an English saying. And if we would continue pronouncing this saying, at the end will be, home is the best. And I am absolutely sure that at the end of any integration for Ukraine, any move of Ukraine, both domestically and internationally, so at the end, there should be created a better conditions for the Ukrainian people inside of Ukraine. And that's why European integration itself has no any value unless the people of Ukraine would live in better conditions. What I mean firstly that for us European integration implementation of the European and European Union standards inside of Ukraine, that Ukrainian people will enjoy all four liberties of the European Union, and primarily it means that Ukrainian industrialists and producers should have free trade with the European Union. Ukrainian people should cross freely the border with the European Union, and at the same time Ukraine should not forget that we have another big formation of countries, political and economic, to the eastern borders of Ukraine. And this is Russia, the Eurasian Union, and the Customs Union. And this is not a secret that Ukraine has a very big scale of trade with the Customs Union. And today we are talking that around 40% of the total Ukrainian foreign trade is with the Customs Union. In the last years, and I would say in the last 2.5 years, when President Yanukovych was elected president of Ukraine, and after the last parliamentary elections, there are many signs of improvement of domestic situation. And Minister Boyko has already started with saying that the key for Ukraine today is to reach stability. And today Ukraine looks a stable country from many point of views. Ukraine today is stable from the political point of view. There is a single team in the government which is addressed to go on with economic reforms. Ukraine is stable from the social point of view, and social standards, maybe not radically, but still, they are moving in the right direction, and Ukrainian people benefit from stable political and economic situation. And all these positive moves make Ukraine to move more surely on the way of the European integration. And in the last years, Ukraine has implemented many reforms never done before. I would cite just few of them. Ukraine has adopted the first tax code in 20 years of its history as an independent state. For the first time in our history, we succeeded to adopt pension reform. By the way, unlike some countries of the European Union, which didn't succeed to adopt the pension reform. Ukraine today has, for the first time in its history, a new European style criminal proceeding code based on the most common norms of criminal procedures of the European countries. Ukraine adopted a new custom code based also on the European standards. And many of these very important for Ukraine pieces of legislation were adopted in close cooperation with European institutions and primarily with the Council of Europe, European Commission. And but here we should all understand that complete integration of Ukraine with the European Union is impossible without strong statements from the European Union that Ukraine one day may be invited for the accession talks. And today, so I'm talking long, or?
No. I'm looking at Javier to see what his response will be to that. Get ready, Javier.
Okay. This year will be extremely important for Ukraine for many reasons. And continuing the title of our today's topic, East or West, I think we all be witnesses that Ukraine, I'm sure, will have strong success in both, in the West and in the East. What regards the European integration for Ukraine? So we have two very noble dates with regard to the European integration fixed for Ukraine. In February, Ukraine will have a Ukraine-EU summit, and today the government is doing its best that the summit will recognize that Ukraine has implemented the first stage of the visa-free action plan with the European Union, and just few pieces of legislation left to be adopted, and I think we'll succeed to do that. And we all expect that at the end of this year, in November, Ukraine will sign the association agreement with the European Union. And today we have all positive statements coming from the European Commission and from the European capitals that this agreement will be ready for signature. At the same time, we expect that there will be many positive developments with the custom union, and we are in negotiations with this big economic and political formation to the east of our borders. And Ukraine has announced that it is our wish to cooperate with the custom union by the formula 3+1. Unfortunately, we don't have now, I stress now, a strong response from the custom union, but Ukraine can be affiliated to any, I also stress, any economic organization in the world in many capacities, to be an associated member, affiliated member. So, but with regard to the European Union today, unfortunately, the statutory documents of this union doesn't allow Ukraine to join this organization in any capacity. Okay, but I think there should be strong bilateral interests, and the custom union also must be interested in having Ukraine an affiliated member by any kind of formula. Today, Ukraine proposes 3+1. So at the end of my short presentation, I would like to say that this year, I'm sure, will bring positive developments for Ukraine. And East or West doesn't mean problems for Ukraine. It means big advantages. And if Ukraine will be a frank, reliable player Ukraine will benefit from both East and West, and home Ukraine will be the best for the Ukrainian people. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Minister Kojata. I feel that so many of those remarks were addressed directly to Javier, so I would like to ask Javier to speak next. And in particular, I would like you to address the point that Minister Kojata made, which is, you know, Ukraine wants to be part of Europe, but it needs to be invited in. What is the European thinking about Ukraine right now? How appealing does it look?
Well, let me start by thanking Viktor Yushchenko for the organization of this lunch.
Lunch, but no lunch.
But no lunch. Well, yeah, lunch. Well, we will eat later. Let me say that fortunately, I am one of those fortunate citizens of the world that eats every day. Some don't have the possibility even to eat every day. I do have. Therefore, I will be very happy not to eat today if we have a good meeting here and a good result. Let's bet on that, and we have a good result out of this meeting. It's the ninth time that you get together during the Davos meetings. I think this particular year, as the foreign minister has said, 2013 is going to be very important, or it can be very important. I mean, voting is a secret right, so I wouldn't say what I have voted at the entrance, but I think by the end of my talk you will have the possibility to, with your imagination, to say what I have voted. This year, 2013, Ukraine has a possibility of signing the association agreement with the European Union. That is a possibility. You have the support of the European Parliament. You are going to have the support of the Commission of President Wanniewski and President Cox from the European Parliament. We probably will have a report, and I hope very much they will report also on the same direction. So, from the European Union and from the Commission that was appointed to decide or to analyze the situation in Ukraine, if Ukraine does the job that has to be done still, by the end of the year, you will have a very important step forward, the signature of what it was for many years, a dream for the Europe of Ukraine. Now, if everything goes right, I hope that by the end of the year, you will have an answer also to the question you have posed to me more clear. But things have to go right. And as you know, still not everything is ready for the yes vote in the European Parliament, for the yes vote among the European Council. And don't want to repeat what it has to be done, but some things are so obvious that has to be done. Ones are on the economic side, others are very political in the dimension. I'm very happy to listen to the foreign minister in the way that Europe is our home. It's a beautiful phrase, it's a beautiful statement, but we have to construct a common house, a common place. And for that, we need the same understanding about the fundamental rights, what does it mean, rule of law, etc., etc., etc. I mean, this stubborn position of the president, and I don't know, with the government also, of trying to analyze the 90s and trying to judge the 90s at this point in time, I think it's a tremendous mistake. You are at the door of getting the possibility of entering the European Union. Please don't waste that time. And it seems to me that in the minds of some, it seems that they just want to waste the time which is in front of us. It has been a long journey, but please do not use the time which is at our disposal now. I have the impression, and I have the wish, and as you know, I've been working for that since very long, many years back. I've been with you, accompanied you in this journey from the very beginning, and I would like to see it completed. Now, this year also will be 2013, to talk about the East and the West. The European Union and Russia, the Russian Federation, will celebrate in a few months, March, the 10th anniversary of what it was, the new agreement between the European Union and the Russian Federation. But we defined the forest space in which we have to construct, etc., etc. It has been a great success to my mind. We are going to celebrate that with a lot of activity between the European Union and the Russian Federation. So at the same time, when we celebrate that, it's a very clear message that the European Union and Russia do want to have a good relationship. Therefore, in Ukraine, in the European Union, or close to the European Union, doesn't have to have bad relations with Russia. So let's get things clear in that sense. Therefore, I think that you have to work as hard as possible in this long, well, short period of time, before the month of November. We have to get the signature of that agreement and open a new page in which the economics of Ukraine, what you have said, the people, the citizens have to feel and to notice that the situation evolves positively. At the end of the day, we work for them. We don't work for the leaders. We work for the people. And let me also say that yesterday you signed a very important agreement with a company, an oil company, very important agreement that if everything goes right, you will have the possibility of having shale gas, which if you use it properly, and you use it properly, that means defending the environment, et cetera, will give you a very important new input in your economy and giving you better perspective for your independence economically. So, in brief, I voted yes to the first question, clear by now, and I really would like to do with you, with the government, with the people of Ukraine, the utmost to get this 2013. Important year, also because in the European Union it will be German elections, which is an important event for the economic development of the European Union, for the move of the European Union, to know what is Germany will be without any elections in the foreseeable future after that one. And I think for those who have been around in Davos, the atmosphere in Davos, it is very positive vis-à-vis the European Union. The European Union has crossed the difficult moment, or the most difficult moment. The time is better, and therefore let's try to use it properly for us Europeans and for you Ukrainians as members, future members of the European Union.
Okay, Ukrainians, yeah, clap. Okay, they like what you had to say, Javier, and I'm glad especially Minister Kojata liked it, because my takeaway from what Javier had to say is a lot of homework for the Ukrainian leaders who are here on stage and who are here in the hall. I would like to turn now to Mr. Kudrin. And, you know, there has been a clear message here from the Ukrainian leaders, a clear European choice, desire to have a 3+1, a close relationship with Russia and the customs union, but a clearly expressed desire ultimately to be part of Europe. What's the Russian view on that?
Если позволите, я буду говорить по-русски. И, значит, я буду стараться говорить как экономист, с экономической стороны. И мне кажется, это сегодня очень важно и прагматично для украинцев. Ну, во-первых, первая мысль. И Россия, и развивающиеся страны все больше стремятся приблизиться к международным стандартам в области рынка, социальной жизни. Мы вступаем в ВТО, мы планируем вступить в OECD, мы поддерживаем или присоединяемся к стандартам открытости. В этом смысле мы тоже идем на Запад. И вопрос, кто быстрее туда идет. Стратегия близка. Давайте подумаем о тактике. Я буду придерживаться некоторых цифр. Вот 2012 год. Украина потеряла экспорт, уменьшила экспорт в Евросоюз на 6%. Примерно, я говорю оценочно, еще не все цифры известны. Понятно, почему Евросоюз был в рецессии. Падение ВВП Евросоюза понятно. Что с российской стороны? Россия росла на 3,5%, но Украина теряла экспорт в Россию на 10%. Что происходит? Почему при растущей экономике России Украина теряет экспорт в Россию? Украина не согласовала подходы по экспорту автомобилей, комплектующих в условиях новых условиях вступления России в ВТО и введения отдельных новых механизмов и потеряла в четвертом квартале 28% поставки автомобильной техники в Россию. В целом по году Украина потеряла 5% рост в автомобильной производстве автомобильной промышленности. Украина не согласовала ряд норматив в части переработки нефти, не создала необходимых условий и потеряла переработку по нефти, производство переработки нефти на 50% в 2012 году. Два крупнейших НПЗ, Лисичанский и Одесский, остановились. Причем это самые современные, готовы производить бензин следующего поколения. Сейчас есть проблемы по транзиту через транспортные системы Украины из России. Потеряла на 18% примерно транзит по нефти и на 20% по газу. Это может, к сожалению, и это падение увеличится. Сейчас в условиях нерешенности и затянувшейся паузы по стандартам торговли с Украиной, Россия ставит вопрос о импортозамещении ранее поставляемых с Украины турбин, комплектующих по автомобилям. Сейчас уже становится вопрос по трубам нефтяного стандарта. И тем самым то, что является непосредственно возможностями Украины сейчас, не откладывая это на десятилетия, может потерять. То есть зачем тактически осложнять на этом векторе свои отношения? Это просто непрагматично. Поэтому у меня ощущение, что в силу наших исторических и кооперационных связей мы тактически можем двигаться к новым западным стандартам правильнее вместе, чем врозь. Мне кажется, что это будет выгоднее для экономики Украины и для жизненного уровня. Пока что Украина имеет половину производства дохода ВВП на душу населения от российских. Поэтому, по-видимому, более рационально двигаться в сторону российских стандартов в области ВВП на душу и производительности. Дальше двигаться вместе к европейским стандартам, от которых Россия примерно в два раза, чуть меньше, чем в два раза отстает. Вот почему мы говорим о том, что, конечно, вопрос о том, Запад или Восток, это надуманный вопрос. Вопрос тактики движения, чтобы не потерять то, что уже имеется.
Okay, that was a very well-made point, Mr. Kudrin, and I noticed the Ukrainian businessmen in the audience wincing when you stated some of those facts, especially when you mentioned the pipes. I was afraid Viktor was going to fall off of his seat. So I am going to be interested in seeing what the reaction of both the Ukrainian government officials and the opposition leaders is to this painful reality that Mr. Kudrin has reminded us of. I'm going to ask Vitaly Klitschko to speak next. Vitaly, we all know about his sporting fame. And by the way, I will share with you one secret. It turns out that Mr. Kudrin is also a boxer, and they were talking about techniques and how boxing is good training for the political arena in the green room. So perhaps later on we can get to that. Vitaly, in his second career, is the leader of the party Udar and is a member of the Ukrainian parliament. Prosimo vas do slova.
Thank you. Boxing is right now is very actual, especially in new Ukrainian parliament, in boxing skills. I hope it's a joke, it will be not true, and we have to work not with the fist, we have to work with our head. It's main point. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, Zegi Herta Damon Herren, Pani Tapanova, Dame Gospoda. I will be like to talk Ukrainian because it's Ukrainian lunch. Шановні колеги, вже багато років ми не можемо вирішити, куди ми рухаємось. Ми рухаємося на захід. Чи ми рухаємось на схід? Ми знаходимося, Україна знаходиться на перехресті і не може визначитися, куди ми рухаємось. І проблеми, які потрібно нам вирішити, накоплюючиться. І на сьогоднішній день багато з цих проблем вже стоять дуже гостро. Нам потрібно ці проблеми вирішити. Мені боляче говорити про проблеми, особливо знаходячись за кордоном. Набагато краще я буду говорити про гарну Україну, але, на жаль, ми повинні говорити про проблеми і яким чином ми можемо вирішити ці проблеми. Ми не можемо на сьогоднішній день не говорити про те, що падає виробництво в Україні. Ми не можемо говорити на цьому фоні, що ми повинні повернути багатомільярдні борги в цьому році. Ми не можемо не говорити дуже поганий інвестиційний клімат і багато фінансових інституцій, багато інвесторів вже йдуть з України. Ми не можемо говорити про мільйони українців, які живуть за межею бідності. Ми не можемо не говорити про 2/3 українців, які кажуть, що Україна на сьогоднішній день рухається не в тому напрямку. Питання, чи може влада на сьогоднішній день вирішити проблеми, які є в Україні, тими методами, які вона застосовує? Відповідь чітка – ні. Корупція, цивілля, добричкове правосуддя – все це відштовхує Україну на узбіччя, воно віддаляє Україну від розвитих європейських країн. Що нам потрібно сьогодні робити, питання, щоб виправити цю ситуацію? Класик політики якось сказав, лише знаючи, де ми знаходимося і куди ми йдемо, ми можемо вирішити, що і як нам робити. Що і як нам робити всім, щоб зробити Україну сильною та заможньою. Багато думок в цьому напрямку і на цьому подіумі вже висловлювали деякі думки. Одні кажуть, що проблема України – це відсутність дешевого газу. Але дешевий газ не вирішить проблеми відсталості технологій. Він не вирішить проблеми деградації економіки. Є інші люди, які кажуть, що проблему України ми можемо вирішити, якщо є сильна рука, яка зможе зробити економічні реформи. Концентрація влади, диктатура – це замороження ситуації. І ми впевнені, що на сьогоднішній день влада показала, що ті реформи, вони неефективні, які спробує влада вирішити сильною рукою. Є думки, що вступ до Мітного Союзу вирішить всі проблеми, які є на сьогоднішній день в Україні. Але я хочу звернутися до всіх, щоб ми думали не короткостроково, а стратегічно. Так, люди нам наводять деякі показники, цифри, вигоди, але ми повинні думати стратегічно. І я впевнений, що ми, тільки рухаючись в напрямок Європи, зможемо побудувати конкурентноспроможну, сучасну економіку рівних можливостей. І на це ми можемо вже нанізати стандарти життя для людей в Україні. І найголовніше, я хочу звернути вашу увагу, це європейські цінності, це людина, це повага до людини, це дотримання закону. Для України нема альтернативи європейського шляху проведення реформ. Саме на здійснення таких реформ ми працюємо
Арсеній Петрович, тут як опозиційні лідери, ми працюємо для того, щоб знищити тотальну корупцію, для того, щоб провести реформи бюджетної системи, щоб повернути місцеве самоврядування в Україну. Але цього ми не зможемо зробити, якщо ми не визначимось послідовною зовнішньою політикою, чітко спрямованою на реалізацію європейського курсу нашої країни. Але разом з тим ми запрогнозовані. Цивілізовані стосунки зі всіма нашими сусідами. І я хочу звернути увагу з нашим найбільшим сусідом Російською Федерацією. Я впевнений, що ми хочемо збудувати ці стосунки на рівноправних засадах, засадах поваги, засадах взаємної вигоди. Але хочу звернути увагу, це дуже важливо, щоб ми відштовхувались виключно з національних інтересів нашої країни. Що потрібно для реалізації європейського вибору України? Для цього потрібен тільки план. І такий план у нас є. Це угода про асоціацію з ЄС та зоною вільної торгівлі. І ми впевнені, що в цьому році ми вже можемо підписати цю угоду, але все залежить від влади, від умов. Зможе влада реалізувати і знищити вибіркове правосуддя, переслідування опозиції, реформу місцевого самоврядування та виборчу реформу. Після цього я впевнений в тому, що наближчі часи ми зможемо підписати цю угоду. Час слів вже закінчується, настав час рішучих дій, і всі ми, українці, наші сусіді, всі хочуть бачити Україну сильною, спроможною, за стабільною економічною та політичною ситуацією. І від нас, від нових політиків, залежить, як швидко ми зможемо реалізувати ці плани.
Ну, дякую дуже, пане Кличко. Я думаю, що зрозуміло, чому ваша партія називається «Удар». Javier, you have heard some Ukrainian enthusiasm for making 2013 the year of Ukraine and Europe. Last, but very much not least, Vitaly referred to Arseniy Yatsenyuk as his partner. In their efforts in Ukrainian politics, Arseniy Yatsenyuk is the leader of Batyivshchina. He is also a member of the Ukrainian parliament. Prosimo vas do slova.
Pleasure to see you, everyone. Bon appetit. You know, the dessert, it's always sweet and tasty. So that's the reason why opposition is served to the dessert. You know, what's on the table today? We got just two choices. The first one is to go to the customs union. And we are heavily welcomed, I would say, to the customs union. That's not an invitation. I would name this as a persuasion to the cooperation. And another one is the European Union. Minister Kudrin is absolutely right. The economic situation is heavily deteriorated in Ukraine. And it's not just only in Ukraine. It happens everywhere. The same goes with the Ukrainian politics. But let's try to elaborate on it. Which way is better? In a short-term perspective, let's be frank, in an extremely short-term perspective, the customs union is simpler, clearer, and better. Cheaper energy price, an easy access to the financial resources, political protection to the incumbent president. Sorry to tell you that, but less democracy and more power. But in the long-term perspective, the customs union is not so, I would say, perfect as the European Union. I strongly believe that the European Union and the European market is much bigger, that the investments are higher, that the number of issues that are tackled in the European Union are definitely much better rather than in the customs union. The EU is just better union. And I want Ukraine to join to the better union, but not to the West Union. And frankly speaking, we do not accept any idea to join Ukraine to any kind of new type of the Soviet Union. Despite the fact that Prime Minister Medvedev said that customs union has nothing to do with the Soviet Union. That's true, because the Soviet Union had an ideology. And I am wondering about the ideology of the customs union. So we as an opposition believe that Ukraine needs to be a member in a long-term perspective, and we fully realize this, of the European Union. That Ukraine needs to move towards the European Union. On the economic side, it's about not just about arithmetics, it's about politics too. We believe that Ukraine needs to have a very sustainable democracy. That's not the democracy what we have today in Ukraine. We have a number of impediments on this road. And I have to name one of these key impediments, except the corrupted government, is Yulia's case, political persecution in the country. And we need to take out of the table this key impediment, which is on our way to the European Union, to stop political persecution, to make Ukraine absolutely and entirely European, to implement strong and tough reforms, starting with the judicial and ending with the economic one. Is it doable? Yes, it's doable. And it's not up to the government to decide the way Ukraine is to move. It's up to the Ukrainian people. And the majority of Ukrainian people share European values. We want to be a part of Europe. We want to have a real cooperation with our Russian friends. But this has to be a cooperation. This has to be an equal cooperation and a win-win situation to both of us. Can we get this target? Yes, we can. We definitely can. Thanks.
Okay, дуже дякую. We've heard another very clear assertion of the European path for Ukraine. I don't even need to ask Arseniy or Vitaly how they voted in that survey. We've also heard some very frank criticism of this Ukrainian government, and I see the Ukrainian government officials beside me trembling with the need to reply. So I'm going to let Vice Prime Minister Boyko respond very quickly, and then we're going to throw it open to the hall. Dobre?
Okay, thank you very much. I think that it's very important when we provide dialogue with our partners from Russian side or from European side, to have possibility to provide equal dialogue. Because today, very often, our connections between us and European Union or us with Russian partners are something similar with connection between teacher and pupil. A teacher from European Union said, here is your home task, do it, and after that, something will be happened. Teacher from Russian side said, join us to Customs Union, after that, you will receive 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here is your also home task. And we are I'm sure that we are not ready to be in this role because we are not pupils. We have young but dynamic democracy. We are improving our society. We are improving our economy. We have questions. We have also, we are not ideal, but we are not ready to say that here is the ideal model to have good connections and cheap energy resources from Russia, meanwhile be presented in the European Union. When we shall find this model, I think we shall receive this goal we are going today. But we are not ready to be in pupil's role a long time, and I'm sure that this position of our government.